If there's one thing that rappers don't like, it's the police. Instead of dealing with them like normal people, most just choose to run. Here's a look at a few rappers who ran from cops. Pop Smoke. Pop Smoke was a rising star in the Brooklyn drill scene who was tragically killed in February 2020. Pop blew up back in 2019 with hits like Welcome to the Party and Dior. He was seen by many to be leading the Brooklyn drill movement and was on his way to being one of the biggest rappers in the world. Unfortunately, he was killed in a robbery gone wrong before fans got to see him reach his full potential. But Pop will always be remembered as an influential artist who brought lots of attention to the Brooklyn drill scene, and other artists inspired by him will carry on his legacy. But before Pop was an international superstar, he was a regular hustler from Brooklyn who was well known in the streets. Pop was a member of the Wu, an umbrella gang that contains different Blood and Crips sets. Pop repped 823 or 8 Deuce Trey Crips and was also closely allied with GS9 and the G-Stone Crips. Just before the rapper died, police pressured him to flip on the gang and give information on both sets, which he refused to do. But that was far from the first time Pop had run-ins with the police. A video surfaced back in 2019 of the rapper getting into it with the cops in the streets of Brooklyn. Pop is from a neighborhood in East Brooklyn called Canarsie, which is where the video takes place. When the clip begins, he's already in mid-argument and things look tense.
You know, handcuffs.
You can immediately identify the rapper by his off-white jacket and black do-rag. About four cops are surrounding him, and one of his friends is standing across the street, filming the whole thing. Pop is in the middle of a shouting match with the police, and his friend can be heard yelling, "Why are you bringing out handcuffs?" Although you can't see it because there's a car in the way, the cops must have been getting ready to slap the cuffs on the rapper and take him to jail. He starts resisting arrest, even though he's outnumbered 4-1. Somehow, he manages to throw him off and takes off running down the sidewalk. One of the cops even falls flat on his face trying to catch up to him, but it's not clear whether they call for backup or manage to catch up because the video ends there. If Pop hadn't become a rapper, he may have had a promising career as a wide receiver or running back in the NFL because he managed to shake off 3 or 4 cops and get away, leaving one flat on his ass. He did earn a scholarship to a competitive prep school in Philadelphia to play basketball and only quit because it was discovered he had a heart murmur. So, it's good to see that his athletic talents were being used even after he became a rapper. It's not clear from the clip what they were arguing about and why they were trying to arrest him. The NYPD is well known for being strict, and Pop Smoke was well known in New York. It may have been that the cops questioned him about something minor, and when they pressed him, he got angry. That wasn't the only time Pop was confronted by police on camera. In another interview with Mel's TV, the rapper was being interviewed outside a grocery store in Brooklyn, and the cops show up just to tell him to clear the sidewalk. One of the dudes in Pop's crew asked the cop if he's new, and when the other rolls up, they start bugging out.
You new? What? You new?
Am I new?
What do you mean, my
name?
The man's is on the corner.
There's two
cops in the corner.
Yeah, no, I think
it's
on, but I
guess
so.
It's
cool. That's all.
Oh! I thought you were on the
movie.
Oh! You gotta see that movie.
You can tell they're familiar with the police in the neighborhood, and being harassed for minor offenses like blocking the sidewalk is normal. The interview ends without anyone getting arrested, but it shows how quick the NYPD is to respond to some minor bullshit like hanging outside a corner store filming an interview. But Pop Smoke isn't the only rapper to book it from the police. This next rapper and his brother were arrested after getting into a crazy Fast and Furious style chase and shootout with the cops, then hit with almost 100 different charges. Here's the wild story. K-Money. K-Money is an up-and-coming rapper from Toronto, Canada. He started gaining attention in 2017 after his song Come Outside racked up over 2 million views within 3 months of being released. The track currently sits at just under 14 million plays. Since then, K-Money has been building a career for himself, along with his brother Casper, who's also a rapper. The two brothers grew up in the Alexandra Park area of Toronto and were known to beef with another neighborhood called Regent Park. The war between Regent Park and Alexandra Park has been raging since the 90s, well before K-Money and Casper hit the scene, and has been responsible for a wave of violence in Toronto. They are some of the most well-known rappers coming out of their neighborhood, so they were holding it down for Alexandra Park in the music scene. When another rapper from Regent Park started to blow up, the beef between the two crews exploded. Smoke Dogg was a rapper from Regent Park associated with a hip-hop collective called Halal Gang. His song Still gained 1 million views within a month of being released, and in 2015, his track Trap House went viral for starting a popular dance move called flipping. The dance was spread even further by major artists like French Montana and Drake, who brought the rapper on a world tour after the track blew up. A Regent Park artist getting a cosign from not only the most famous artist from the city, but one of the most popular artists of all time was bad news for the boys in Alexandra Park, and after Smoke Dogg blew up, the war between the two neighborhoods began to get crazy. In April 2017, Casper dropped a diss track called All Your Friends Are Dead, aimed at Smoke Dogg. Not long after, Smoke Dogg was jumped and had his chain snatched. Casper dropped another diss track a few weeks later called Burberry Closet, wearing Smoke Dogg's chain in the video. After that, K Casper and K-Money's crib was shot up multiple times, and it was an all-out war. Smoke Dawg recorded his own diss track called Fountain Freestyle and shot the video in Alexandra Park, the housing complex that K-Money and Casper were from. This was the ultimate sign of disrespect, and after that, the Alexandra Park boys were done with music and took the beef to the streets. On the night of their arrest, Casper and K-Money decided to pop some Xanax and shoot up Regent Park in broad daylight. They put on some ski masks and hopped in a black rental van, armed and ready for action. They let off some shots into a crowd of people, which triggered a response from the police. For some reason, the cops already had a team of undercover policemen not far from the scene who came to investigate right away. It didn't take long to figure out who did it once they came across a black SUV with a group of Xanned out rappers inside wearing ski masks in the middle of the afternoon. The police cut them off trying to drive away from a parking spot, but the drugs must have given them superpowers because rather than obeying the cops, they hit the gas station and swerved around them in the oncoming traffic. This is where they went full Grand Theft Auto and managed to avoid the cops while swerving in and out of traffic. They slammed into a couple taxis as well as a police car, but still managed to continue the chase. At one point, they were blocked in and traffic coming from the other direction was too tight for them to get around. But rather than surrender, they drove into the sidewalk and continued the chase with pedestrians everywhere. They ended up crashing the vehicle down the block and got out on foot. They booked it through a parking garage and hopped a fence on the other side. The two brothers ended up in a working construction site and continued to run from the police while dodging cranes and forklifts. Eventually, they ran as far as they could and were tackled by police. Allegedly, after he was arrested, K-Money told the cops to tell the media that the infamous Casper and K-Money had been caught and that they did it all for the clout. The wild chase definitely did help bring attention to the rappers, but not for the reasons they probably hoped. Just a week after the chase, Smoke Dawg was shot and killed in broad daylight by another rapper in an unrelated beef. So, they did all that to try to scare their op, only for him to be murdered by a different crew. But it all goes to show you how wild the streets of Toronto can get. Casper and K-Money had a hard time beating the case because the entire thing was captured on security cameras in the neighborhood as well as police dashcam footage. The two brothers along with other associates were hit with 97 charges and it's estimated that the case caused $1 million worth of damage. They pled guilty to the charges and apologized to the court admitting that they were high and not thinking straight. K-Money was sentenced to 7 years and Casper received 18 months. Although the chase was pretty crazy and definitely brought more attention to the rappers, it didn't seem to help their music career and now they won't even be able to enjoy it. Casper may still have a chance to revive his career after being released, but it seems like K-Money might be done for good. Surprisingly, Casper and K-Money aren't the only rappers to get into a crazy chase with police. This next rapper was arrested and assaulted by a cop after getting pulled over for reckless driving and attempting to flee the scene. Here's what happened. Lil Baby. Lil Baby is one of the hottest rappers coming out of Atlanta with songs like Drip Too Hard and Yes Indeed doing crazy numbers online. Baby started blowing up back in 2017 and was quickly accepted by the industry, having grown up around other big artists like Gunna and Young Thug. Plus, his association with legends in the Atlanta rap scene like Gucci and P from Quality Control Records definitely helped him in the industry. Lil Baby has gone on to drop major chart-topping projects and cement himself as one of the leading voices in the new wave of trap rappers. But being a famous rapper doesn't save you from police harassment, and in February 2019, Lil Baby got into a chase after a cop claims he was driving recklessly. Lil Baby was driving down the highway in Atlanta in an orange Corvette and caught the attention of a Georgia State Patrol officer who was stopped at a red light. The officer claims that he saw Baby change lanes without signaling, then increase in speed and pass vehicles in a reckless manner. After Baby passed the officer, he turned on his lights and tried to get him to pull over. The cop claims that at that point, rather than pulling to the side of the road, Baby began to accelerate and weave in and out of traffic. Once the trooper caught up to him, the rapper tried to accelerate and change lanes, but was stuck. That's when the cop got out of his car and told him to get out of the Corvette. After that, Lil Baby surrendered and got out on the ground. A fan caught the arrest on camera and drives by as the rapper is laid out on the road restrained while the cop is hovering over him with his foot on his leg. Lil Baby was brought to the Atlanta City Detention Center, but was released later that day. He was charged with failure to use a turn signal, reckless driving, and evading the police. Given the amount of money and industry connections that Lil Baby has, he likely got hit with little more than a fine or a slap on the wrist. The way that the cop had him restrained in the video, you would think that he had a strap on him or at least some weed in the car, but the only thing he was guilty of was reckless driving. Whether the cop was really concerned about the safety of the public or he just spotted a famous rapper and thought he might be able to catch him on some bullshit, it's hard to tell. Baby posted a video to Instagram not long after, where his face looks pretty swollen from being held on the ground. He even goes into freestyle and references the arrest rapping, "First show I rocked him, next show I'm on the way. Police got my face swole, I don't give a f though.
First show I rocked him, next show I'm on the way. Police got my face swole, I don't give a f though."
So Baby is clearly pissed about the arrest, but isn't letting it stop his grind. He also shared some footage of the sold-out show he was performing at just after spitting the freestyle, so the arrest didn't seem to faze him too much. He was lucky to not have anything incriminating on him at the time of the arrest, or it could have been much worse. He probably just saw the red and blue lights, and his old instincts told him to flee. Hopefully, Lil Baby can learn to go a little slower next time he takes his Corvette out for a spin so he doesn't attract any unwanted attention, or hire a driver so he doesn't feel tempted to get in any more crazy chases.